Hi, it's Philip. I show you my new PKG for QNAP system, MyNS. MyNS is a group of commands to manage yourself, namespace, and cgroup only by command line. The target is to propose more resolution for short or program, and eventually, and a good idea is to add a network stack. So each route or program can have its own network access to the QNAP itself or to the LAN. It's a set of commands. All are new, but some are little modified just to run better on QNAP. The target of the demonstration is to use an existing route and to add namespace to isolate it, but also to create a new stack, network stack, to use it directly without using the network of the QNAP. All are done by commands, but the first element is a script, because we don't want to enter all the elements. But in fact, one command are really important, the start of the route in the namespace. Okay, now the demonstration. So here you have a list of shell scripts. One, the gcnet is for starting the route in the namespace. MyServe is an inter-exchange between QTS and the short based on NamePipe. Network is the shell we start inside the short to start the private stack. So it's a very simple shell script. We just put up the interface, start the HCPD to have a client DHCP on this interface and start the SSH private in this system. So I can now start the route. If I see here, you see there were absolutely no interface except the current interface on my QNAP. I start. Okay, so we set the MAC VLAN, we start the route. So we have the PID because we use them after. We attach the MAC VLAN interface to the NetNS created just before. And we run the network shell that we just see it. And so now all is ready to run. To join the console, it's through the screen command, so I can attach this console. Okay, I am in my route. If I look at the network, you can see that there were now MVN link with a specific address on the same LAN than the QTS. If I redo the command here, you have no thing that are listed. If I search for the mount, it's the same. Absolutely nothing up here. Even if I have an access to my public share, for example. So it's very easy. How we can do this? All this mount to run my system. It's using a specific file named fstab that you created before where you list all the mount you need. So here I mount internally to the route the proc, the sys by system, the dev using udev, the dev pts for the screen, and here it's outside the route. I bind I move my chair, my public chair, to the same path inside the chute. So you have nothing to do, nothing happens in the QTS, but you have all your mount need. You have full access and that you are able to use the system. So if now I want to go to this to my lobby, I can just create a new session. Okay, enter the IP. It's always the same because it's a server and I have a dedicated MAC address. Okay, it's same. Yes, it's a new. I can enter, for example, root and my password. Okay, and here I compare. Oops. It's in the chute. We have exactly the same access, same visibility. You can access to all the data and start any application inside. Here I can use detach of screen to free it and it continue to run in the background without any impact on the QTS side. The only important thing is how to manage the IP net NS link, because you need to have you are limited in this usage if you don't have a namespace. But it's relatively easy to manage this by creating a link in the NetNS folder from the proc with the PID provide. And here you have all the private namespace, so you can use them directly to manage and do command that you want to do. So it's a total isolation in terms of moonpoint, in terms of inter-process communication, in terms of network with this private stack and private IP in PID number. In UTS, it's the name of the system, the host name of the system. Just one more thing. When I go back, I reattach the console. If I do ps3-p to see all the process and the process ID, you can see that all is attached to the first, the process ID 1. It's a batch because I use them, and we have all the process. So also, the process ID are different in the chute isolate and in the QTS. Okay, I think it's finished. So you can see that it's really easy with a very simple command line to generate a totally isolated system. The network you can use Mac VLAN, you can use Mac VTAP, you can use virtual Ethernet to make a link, a direct link between the QTS and the chute. You can use also or dedicate real Ethernet link to the chute. So you have all the possibility to do what you want and to isolate not all the system, eventually just one program, as I do here with Dropbear. Okay, thank you for your attention. Bye.